David Zuritsky for the Bond Experience. Welcome back. I'm sort of on hallowed sartorial ground right now. I'm here in the ORLEBAR BROWN corporate office, right in the heart of London. You can see some of the artifacts from some of the work. But more importantly, I'm going to be taking you on a journey. I know that you love the different heritage lines and the different James Bond pieces that they put together. Well, today we're going to meet some of the creative individuals behind them. Who inspired them? What inspired them? What is the journey that they took? And more importantly, how do they come up with these incredible pieces? And you may see, dare I say, just a few new ones to boot. I'm going to go out on a limb and think by the end of this video, you're going to be both shaken and a little stirred. So now at this point, we are in the showroom and we have Simon.
Great to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Simon, tell everybody, what do you do here at ORLEBAR BROWN?
I am the design director here at ORLEBAR BROWN.
Okay, so beyond that, what does a design director do? It sounds great.
Well, the design director, closely within the whole company, obviously, especially closely with Adam as the creative director and original founder of the company. And we work across all the collections, all the clothing, whether it be all the product categories from swim to polo shirts to where we're sort of developing sort of new areas as well, whether it's more to the tailored pieces like you're wearing yourself today, to knitwear to the whole board. And we do four ready-to-wear collections a year, and then we also do little projects like we're working on today at the same time.
And we're everybody at home right now, let me tell you what's going through their head. They're like, move! Simon, David, move! We're going to move in a second, but we love the journey of how these things come to bear, because we as customers, we get them at home, we open the box, we see the wrapping, the presentation, everything smells good, it looks good. We love all of that.
Yeah.
But what they don't realize is there's a Simon behind the scenes. So when you have a collection of this, where does the conversation begin? Are you sitting in your corporate boardroom and somebody goes, I have an idea?
We start off with a concept, with a design concept, whether it be a small capsule like this or whether it be a full-blown collection like we do, like I say, four times a year. And that would start off with an inspiration, which we work on with Adam, and on starting points for the season. And we generally base that around words or characters or imagery or muses, all sorts of things can starting point. More and more what we're doing in a moment with prints as well become very important in as far as the starting points. And of course, color as well.
Color is so important, especially for
Absolutely.
This particular brand.
Yes.
You can't see what I'm seeing, but there's color everywhere. If you were looking for black and white, this is not the office to be in.
No.
But I will say this, because this is a Bond line, is there sort of a mood board? Is there sort of an angle that you take in this case?
Yes, I mean, we would reference, Bond archive, Bond imagery.
Right.
Over the years, we've had the luxury of actually going to see some of the original pieces of Bond clothing.
I'm not jealous.
What have you, to go in there.
Not a bit.
Which has been obviously a wonderful opportunity to explore into that, yeah.
And that just really inspires you. That's part of the muse, as you said.
Absolutely, yes. It's the muse, and then it's like, okay, how do we interpretate that for people to actually, to buy into the clothing, to buy into the feeling, to buy into the world itself.
And by the way, when we are doing this video, this is a day after the launch of the 007 60th anniversary line of clothing from ORLEBAR BROWN. I love the approach. All right, now we're getting into it, everybody. Everybody's like, come on, enough with the chit-chat. First of all, talk to me about this piece right here.
Well, this is like a really sort of the starting point for something new within the capsule. I think you could probably tell me where the inspiration for you comes through from.
I'm thinking the Dr. No gun barrel.
Well done.
Yeah. This isn't hard, people.
It's probably such an iconic, obviously it's a massively iconic thing for Bond, massively iconic thing within cinematic history. So it's a great privilege to be able to use that. We've taken it, we've interpreted it into sort of ORLEBAR BROWN sort of spirit as well. So taking it into our photographic world with what we do with swim shorts, taking the iconic Bond imagery of the gun barrel, and then colouring it to within our world where people actually want to wear swimwear sort of colourways going into there. So there's a lovely sort of navy blue sort of tones there running through the short, and then you just have the one contrasting Dr. No icon going into one of the.
I love that. It's so this does two things for those of you kind of playing at home, and we'll get some close-ups of this, of course. It is not only an ode, an homage, a doff of the hat to Dr. Know Where It All Began. This could be a very subtle pattern. I'm telling you from afar, and I'm holding this back for a reason. It looks like an interesting navy polka dot and white pattern.
Absolutely, yeah.
With like a little tiny hidden bond moment, if you will.
Totally, yeah. So it's a nice way of moving things on. It's a very sophisticated way of wearing into the shorts as well. Bond is the ultimate of sophistication in the sort of clothing. So
that's true.
We're very proud of this one. I think it's come through very, really, really nicely, and it's in our classic sort of bulldog style.
Yeah, that's a great mention that it is bulldog, not setter. But for those of you who do not want something so subtle, no. You want something whimsical. You want to wear the poster on yourself. We've got the poster.
We've literally got the poster on the short, yeah.
So tell us about this. Is this a re-release, if you will?
It is indeed, yeah. It's a re-release. Nothing's really sort of changed on there. Just, a great piece and great to have it out there again in what we're doing. Yeah, there is a real sort of detail which goes into these shorts. So the way they're framed, the way the actual artwork is interpreted onto a piece of clothing,
right.
It's a 360 degrees sort of process. What goes into it, taking into account all the components of which build up to whether it be the waistband, the side adjuster, how we get the print on here, and then here it's all plain. These are also laid out on a complete sort of flat pattern,
yeah.
And then printed onto all these sort of components. So you get like the perfect lineup of the writing from the imagery on the poster, how it all sort of blends in across together then.
That's a great point. You know, we don't even think about these things, but, and yes, here comes a terrible pun. It just came to me, but it looks seamless. There's a million seams on this. I know how these things are
absolutely
put together, but it does look seamless. So if the eye trains you that you're just looking at a poster on a person, as opposed to, it's a mishmash of different things.
Absolutely. And that's on both the shorts as well. They're both sort of interpreted into that. So the actual, the circles are put onto it at a slight angle so you get the right join in the right seams.
Makes sense.
And way it all goes through. Absolutely.
So. All right, well, staying on the theme of Connery and also keeping very classic, stick with us on this. You ready for this? I feel like there should be, I'm going to add a drum roll. You'll see later. We've got the onesie. It's back. And by the way, do not adjust the color on your computer. Is this an ivory? Is it a white? What would you call this?
It is. Well, we wanted to take the inspiration of Ursula Andress in her swimsuit and taking those sort of iconic sort of the colorway of coming from there, basically. So that's how we sort of reinterpreted the garment through into bringing in this sort of colorway.
I love this. And again, if you've been on my channel, you know that the onesie was one of those things that would sell out. They would put some up.
Absolutely.
It would sell out, put them up.
Actually, overnight.
Then they re-released and people got all excited and it's sold out, but it's back in a very interesting way. I love this too, because I've got to make mention to those of you who are like, do I want to wear something Bond? These are like a nice throwback to the rompers that it doesn't have to be James Bond.
No.
This could be just something in Miami or Saint-Tropez or New Jersey.
Classic resort wear, isn't it?
Yeah, maybe not New Jersey. No, New Jersey. There's some nice beaches in New Jersey. You shouldn't do that.
Absolutely.
But all right, so I don't mean to do a Sophie's Choice,
okay.
But this is one of the top favorites of my collection. This is something that the alarm bells are going to go off because I will slip this into my bag. This is a navy one. Look at the gold buckle. Look at how the gold buckle stands against this navy. And this is a dark, is it navy or midnight
it's
blue?
It's midnight navy, yeah. So, with the navy blue sort of coming through into here, it was James Bond's tuxedo was always midnight navy.
That's right.
The black, so midnight navy made the ultimate sort of color to go for.
I love this. And again, it's this thing where it looks rich but not unapproachable.
Yep.
And I think it still plays along with the brand of that whole whimsy. There's not everybody, I get it, who's watching this that would wear a romper and things like that, but this is something that you can do and it's approachable.
Absolutely.
All right, so we're sticking with Dr. No.
Absolutely.
And what do we have here?
We have here now the toweling polo shirt coming in. So this is in our really taking inspiration from the fabrication which Sean Connery polo shirt was in. Now it's just, you know, and it's also a very iconic fabric of what we do here at ORLEBAR BROWN as well. So it's in a terry toweling fabrication. We've got the bright popper red. We've also got other colours which you'll see as well in a little bit. But this is really taking the original dot sequence, the coloured dot sequence from the film, and picking one of the colours there as a sort of real pop within this colour of story. So that's where the red came from.
You know, I have to tell you something. When you first came out with the bulldog with the poster on it. And everybody said, well, why did they put a red shirt on him? And I said, well, that's the postcards, the color cards in the theater, because they had to make them very attractive. Yes. They had to add color. You couldn't have all blues and things like that. It has to attract the eye. To me, this is like you've actually brought that to life.
Yeah. Absolutely.
So how interesting would it be if you wore those with this as a connection point?
Yeah, no, nice. Yeah, absolutely. Mm,
Christmas, it's coming. and then, of course, we had to rejuvenate.
You have to have the iconic color. Yeah.
Is this, and maybe this is a retail question more than anything, is this an incredibly popular shirt for the
absolutely,
brand?
Absolutely, yeah. And it's a real, you know, starting from, inspired by, you know, literally from James Bond. So it's a, you know, a real sort of iconic piece of what we do. You've got the lovely sort of rib collar going on there with like a nice sort of contrasting between the two, between the terry fabric on the base and then the rib onto there. And just with our really nice, sort of, you know, our signature sort of details there sort of going through.
The tag and everything.
The tag and the little red stitching detail as well.
What I love about this shirt too, for those of you out there that are like, well, you know, some of the ORLEBAR BROWN polos, you know, like the Sebastians may not fit me or my body type. This is actually very forgiving. A medium fits me. I'm a 41 chest. I'm a 31 inch waist. Even if you have a little bit of room below in your lower GI, this is something that gives. I've seen all genders, all walks of life, all ages wear this shirt. It's very approachable.
Absolutely. It, but still has our, you know, all our tailored signatures to it. So it's still, you know, tailored to fit in that right way.
Will it make you look like Sean relaxing. Connery? No, but you'll feel like Bond with it. And again, I mean, just this midnight blue, so James Bond. You could see, and by the way, lest you think that Simon and I did this on purpose, can we come close
coordinated
together?
Coordinated up here today, yeah.
I mean, look at this. We've got the stone colored. I mean, it's obnoxious, but we're brothers for life because of it.
Absolutely.
But this is beautiful. Now, this is something that, even if it wasn't Bond, this is just something that everybody would go to.
Absolutely. Yeah, it's a classic navy blue polo shirt as well at the same time. So, but yeah.
But and by the way, for those that follow the sartorial Bond, I know you have a million blue polo shirts. I know that your spouse has probably complained about it, but the toweling and the ribbing on this gives it something very unique.
Such a great fabrication, yeah.
Yeah.
And such a comfortable fabrication to actually wear. So.
That's the uniqueness of it. Now, we've got to bring it all together.
Uh-huh.
Have to have something so you don't walk around like Pooh Bear. So pants are really good. And now this is kind of almost like a kind of an accurate replica, if you
absolutely.
Will.
Absolutely. So yes, we're back to the whole complete look going on here. So yes, literally this is one of the pieces which we pulled from the archive right from the beginning, bringing in the pocket detailing, the waistbanding, etc. going through. So yes, it really is one of those iconic sort of pieces and really sort of...
Yeah, so I'll give a quick testimonial because not only do I own these, I've worn these in Jamaica at GoldenEye. So for those of you that don't like skinny jeans or skinny pants, this is that, not that. This is not skinny. It's not also relaxed or loose. It's somewhere beautifully in the middle.
Yeah, so it has that tailored fit to it.
Yes. Yeah, it's got a nice taper, but it's so comfortable.
A bit of ease to it, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. And it breathes too as well.
Yes,
because I didn't go to Jamaica in the right time of year. I went in the summer the first time, and that was on me. But you come out of the pool, maybe you're a little chilled, and then, of course, Dr. Julius's... Now, wait a minute. I noticed something different. This is a real organic moment, folks. I'm going to have to get up close and personal. We'll get some up close shots. You've got something new in the tag that my robe at home doesn't have. It says Dr. No's 60th anniversary.
Absolutely.
What? That's quite neat.
Indeed. So, yeah, just two little tweaks to move things on.
But other than that, is the robe essentially the same?
The robe is exactly the same. We've got the lovely slightly sort of contrasting in the two different piles of toweling going through, and then just sort of hid away on the inside there we have.
Yeah, we'll get up a close and personal with that. Absolutely. That's just, you know, it almost, dare I say, it is a little bit of an imaginative moment. It seems like you stayed at Dr. No's willingly. Imagine that. And you stole the robe from the hotel.
Absolutely.
As nobody has done before. But you don't have to, because it's right here.
Okay,
Sophie's Choice Part 2, which doesn't exist because she can only choose one. But this is so sumptuous.
It's lovely.
To me, this says holiday.
Yeah.
So this is the same thing, but in navy.
In navy blue, exactly the same detailing, exactly the same. Like I say, the nice contrast is going through onto the lapel and the body shape. And then again, we're still carrying through the little Dr. Julius Snow.
I love it.
Branding that.
This would have been in the closet, an alternate version.
Absolutely.
If you will. It was filmed, but it wound up on the cutting room floor, is what you're saying. But I love as a designer, you can sit there. Think about the 60-year anniversary of James Bond. You can repaint the story a bit by doing this.
Absolutely, but keeping it all within the James Bond language and still with all the influences of James Bond.
I love it.
Within that sort of story.
All right, I've got a terrible last question for you.
Okay.
You ready for this? Okay. You're a Bond fan, obviously.
Of course, yeah.
So as this collection is released and all of us rabbit fans get rabbit over it, it's not the end. James Bond always returns at the end of the film. Will there be any more collections in the future?
There very might possibly be.
What? Didn't see that coming. Really? You can't say anything,
though. No. On its way, but...
There are two people off-site that you can't see, one with a silencer, one with a blow dart. Intimidating? I think so. So we can't. But Simon, thank you so
Pleasure.
Much.
Thank you
for opening up your designer and creative home to us. And thank you for taking us through the collection.
Pleasure. Thank you very much.
It was such
indeed.
A pleasure.
Thank you.
Let's go check out some more things. Okay, so the ORLEBAR BROWN team has an amazing... Yeah, you hear the music. They are going to be putting me into the same experience that they used to create the video portions of the ad. So I have no idea what to expect. I could get hurt. Let's see what happens. So over here.
I'm standing in place. And then what I'll do is I'll punch you on the set.
Yeah. All right. Straddle it or just...
No, I'll actually go to this chair.
Yeah.
And then... Okay.
Just crank
it
up.
Don't crank it. No crank. Thank you. All right.
I'm doing a little higher.
Yeah.
Feels good?
Yeah, it's good.
Okay.
And then,
for a moment.
And then, press the... Yeah.
I'm desperately... making sure I don't take my foot off of this.
Yeah, I'm already going to buy it. Turns out. Mm-hmm. You did the line on.
Quite a channeling, huh?
You're right, that was convenient.
So the polo was great, but this is ORLEBAR BROWN. We got to get a little bit more avant-garde. So yes, I had to do the navy onesie. It's one of my choices, one of my wish list things. So we're going to replicate this moment, but with the onesie. Let's do it.
A little bit higher, yeah.
You know what? I'm a New Yorker, so I tend to walk fast.
Yeah, New York a lot of the time.
That's good.
Yeah,
it's
good.
Thanks for watching this episode. If you want to be up on the latest from the Bond Experience, just click on this subscribe and subscribe to our channel. You're going to get all the latest and greatest information, plus some exclusive content. And by the way, speaking of content, here's something especially for you, just because we know you. Talk to you soon.